Alright, guys. We are going to see how we do. Hopefully, our leg is better. But we will see. So I'm looking at a guide. As far as big threats, and the two extreme ones seem to be Teemo and Pantheon, and yeah, those are hard. I also see Malphite, Gnar, Yorick, Singed, Jace, Rumble, and Renekton. It says that Garen is even. Cho'Gath, Darius, yes. That's not good. Where's Garen? There we are. So there are a couple ways to build jacks. I'm sure most people kind of know what they are. There's the damage one. There's the damage one that's got, you know, Ginsu's, and you can also get Blade of the Ruined King. Basically, just like lots of attack speed, lots of on-hit damage synergy with his passive and his ultimate. And then there's situational ones, like if they've got a ton of AP, you know, you just build AP items, or, fucking Teemo. I shouldn't go Jax. Teemo's just so hard for me. Jax is a good counter to Yasuo, so maybe Yasuo's top and Teemo's mid or something, I don't know. If that's the case, Jax is actually one of the few champions that one-on-one can do really good against Yasuo. Because Yasuo's all melee. He's mobile, but he has to dive in. He dives out. Jax can kind of, basically, just like if Yasuo comes out and he pops a Z. If Yasuo doves away, then you jump away, and it's all good. But yeah, I know we got three AD attackers, so Zed's here, so not really paying attention. My lag is still not good. Well, I might troll this game. If he wanted to go. Alright. I probably could have been more mature, but it's just a much better for matchup for Zed to go top against Teemo and me to go mid, and could have played it out, but doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. Probably doesn't matter with this leg anyway. I probably won't be able to play today. Funny thing is, I have more farm now than I would if I was top. That's actually pretty funny. I haven't seen actual Intain for a very long time. This is actually kind of refreshing and fun. You might say it's a dick move to not leave, but that may be true, but it was the right call, and you know, it's just both people have a solo lane, so that's fine, but 1 second, Carrie! When this game is over, I can, period. That is a little sad. I mean, I did kind of try to strong arm him out of the lane, but I mean, this is just such a much better matchup for me and for him. It's just kind of silly. Might say that I'm a dick, but he's a pretty big dick too. No communication before, no communication during. He didn't like say anything until we're actually in lane and I was farming. But here's the thing, like, I can't farm against Teemo. This is a much better matchup for both of us. Part of the reason I went Jax is because Jax is a really good counter to Yasuo. And actually Olaf as well. Not necessarily a counter to Olaf, but he can trade with him pretty fine. Teemo's back mid, so I'm gonna head top. Yeah, again, I'm not justifying or saying that I did the right thing, or, well, I mean, I did do the right thing in terms of the lane switch, but yeah, he didn't agree to it, and we live in a consent culture, which is important, but yeah, no. I can play lots of champions, I just don't want to. That's probably why I'm in silver. That's probably why I'm in silver. That's why probably why poor people smoke. Why people do drugs. Just get angry and bitter. Angry and bitter. Okay. Nice. I mean, this may sound weird, but we can actually still win. Because Zed's, even though he's feeding a boatload of... I mean, I was gonna lose so hard, so hard, especially with this ping. Ugh, that's amazing. When you have more deaths than every single other person in the entire game combined, that's a problem, though. 803, yeah. He's gonna win it. Okay. Man, I need to call my internet company. I have no idea what's going on with this. This is so weird. What's this Zed's name? Poppers OP. I mean, yeah, we probably can't win, but wouldn't that be funny if we actually, like, won 4v5? I may do some things, but I would never ever intentionally feed 18 kills. Like, ever. I mean, I've gone in a game where I've been like 0 and 10. I'm not saying I'm good. But that's pretty funny. So we have physical, physical, physical. That sucks. But we can go. I don't know if Tiamat would even help us now. You're not supposed to tell other people what to do, but if you see somebody like throwing trash on the road, you should say something. I mean, yeah, I'm not saying that there's like the perfect plan or this or that, but it was the right call. I mean, if you wanted to win like a long game, that was going to be the best chance was to switch lanes. And Zed's like the guy that, even though you're right, instead of changing his mind or doing this or that, he pulls out a gun and shoots you because he doesn't want to be told what to do. That's a good Gragas, though. Good Gragas. Don't know if that was his burst or if it was just my lag. You know what's really sad in terms of KDA and like farm at this point in the game? I'm actually doing better than most of the games I've played this past week. And I'm pretty sure that's probably because the other team saw the inting and when it went, you know, 5 ints and it didn't stop, they probably stopped caring, so they knew they weren't gonna lose. Man, no, I'm going to have to definitely figure out my internet. Oof. No, I can't even play, even if I... Oof. Even if I wasn't super, super behind, or even if the Zed wasn't feeding, this is just awful, awful lag. I mean, how do you go 1-28 without actually like getting banned? I'm coming, Carrie. I just the game just finished.
Do you want it upstairs?
No, I'll come downstairs. All right, gotta report Zed. Super intentional feeding.
I need you eventually. I was in a game, and our Zed went. The game was 23 minutes long. How many times do you think Zed died? The game was 23 minutes long. How many times do you think Zed died? No. 28. 28 times. He walked to every lane, walked under the turret, and died over and over every time he could. I think he died as much as was humanly possible. It was amazing. Meh. He was angry and defeating. I think he was tilted in general, but I was recording that game too. But I think what happened was, like, in the beginning, we talked about how we would switch lanes because they picked Yasuo, and Yasuo was very good against Zed because of the wind wall. He can keep Zed from moving around. And Teemo was really good against me, so I said, we were talking about in lane, and the thing was saying, like, hey, let's switch lanes. I'll go against Yasuo, you can go against Teemo, and he didn't say anything, but everybody thought it was a good idea, so I went Jax because I can't handle Teemo, but I was going to go mid. So I went mid, and then he got really mad at me because he never said anything until I started farming in his lane, and he's like, what the fuck are you doing? And I was like, where have you been this whole time? Have you not been reading anything? Like, Jesus. Anyway, you don't actually have to come. It's really sad. Well, I mean, you can always make more, right? Alright. Oh, okay. Love it here. Come here.
なんせ俺とスタイルがやたら似てっからな。 結果それがブロックしづらい独特の間合いを作り、もらったぜ。 相手してやるよ。翔吾くん、練習終わった？ああ、悪い悪い。今終わった。最近できた帰省の彼女じゃん。
あれ、亮太くん？つうわけだ。じゃあな、亮太くん。
試合が進むほど技を奪われて攻撃力が下がる一方だ。こうだよ。はい、ここまで完璧に。
技のストックも底をついてきたってのに。そうだそうだ、しかも女も俺が取っちまったんだっけ。
勘違いしてるよ、あの子のこととか。モデルと付き合ってるってステータスが欲しかっただけなんすよ、あれは。戻れ！完全無欠の模倣、パーフェクトコピー。必ずそこへ行く。邪魔すんじゃねえよ。
スクープショット。アツシと装飾で反応と迫力。逆転！会場逆転だ。
明石の言う通りだったってのかよ。ぶっ潰してやる。勝つのはお前じゃない、俺だ。
会場ならまだ出てこねえぜ。知るがバカ。何しようが俺の勝手だろうが。じゃあそうさせてもらうわ。よし、時間だ。行くぞ。じゃあ行こうか。
慎太郎とは僕がやる。
頭蓋骨。
高いぞ。いずれそれを思い知ることになる。すぐにわかるよ。
緑まとい証。ノーフェイクでいきなりスリ
ー。赤チンの目はオフェンスもディフェンスも全て無力にする。図が高いぞ。この目の前全ての動きは先を読まれる。
ハーフタイムまで同点だったのに。ダメだ、シュート体勢に入れない。
信じられない正確さだ。
無駄だ。
どけ。
そこから起き上がらないことこそ恥。
僕がいつ気を抜いていいと言った。試合はまだ終わっていない。だがもし負けたら好きなだけ僕を非難しろ。敗因は僕の今のゴールだ。両の目をくり抜いてお前たちに差し出そう。
そういう危うさが奴にはある。
残念だがこの試合はもう終わりだ。
たとえお前のエンペラー相手も俺たちのシュートは止められない。
絶対は僕だ。僕には先が全て見えている。来る。
なめんじゃねえよ。
まさか布石はすでに打たれていたとはな。
これが奇跡の世代キャプテン明石エースか。
ごめんなさいね。うるさいのは苦手なのは。
試合終了。86-70で楽山高校の勝ち。
絶対負けてはならない。それが帝王の宿命だ。
別に疑ってるわけじゃねえ。もしあいつが戻ってこなかったら、今度は俺があいつを助けるんだ。
くそ。
安心しろよ。
やっと少しテンション上がってきた。せいぜい楽しませてくれよ。
鏡。
だがこの均衡はおそらくすぐに崩れるのだよ。
はっきり言って
青峰っちが負けるとは思えない。
そんなことがありえるのか。青峰より鏡の方が上だというのか。
後半始まっちまうぞ。
勝つためにはやはりあいつが不可欠。しかし
出てくれんじゃねえか鉄。やってくれん。
すんのかよ。
黒子リベンジ止め。ナイスパス。
マーク
鏡越しにしか見ない。
くっ、
くっ、
くっ、くっ、くっ、く
っ、ミスディレクションは使えば使うほど効力が薄くなり、そのミスディレクションが完全に切れたんだ。もはや聖鱗に打つ手はない
けど。恥じることでもないで。1、2年生だけのチームでウィンターカップ出場。来年またチャレンジしや。
また今度じゃダメなんです。今勝つんだ。
消えた。
テーピングを巻き直してくれないか。
あ、はい。
最後まで持ってくれ。
発動。ああ
。ちょっと青峰くん、始まるよ。みんな言ったし。
清先輩、ちょっといい。
出てた。
青峰を止めなければ聖鱗に勝て。
青峰君を止めます。
まさか外させたんか、あいつが。
僕には青峰君を止めることはできません。聖鱗は負けない。
プッシング黒9番。
よっしゃ
ー。ありゃ、
はい、あの、すいません、すいません。
もしそれがチームの勝利のためなら
無理で、
絶対取り返すぞ。キューバ、
宣言撤回するぜ。最高だなお前。
神の方が早いやと。どうなっとるんや。
一ついいですか、
うん、
あの時の拳をまだ合わせてません。
分かったよ、次は勝つからな。
はい。
キュート、
against the Tai Chi guy in a grappling match. He's going over some rules like no slamming, no picking up and slamming, or any slammings that have arcs. So no suplexes, unfortunately. The Chi Master's got a lot of Chi in his belly. His belly's bigger than Xu Xiaodong's belly. Xu Xiaodong, if you see this, I'm joking, okay? I know you like to joke. The guy was trying to throw him. Look at this, man. Push him out. See, this is not exactly a slaughter. The student of Xu Xiaodong's is... Oh, he's getting serious now. Oh! Look at this. Oh! Simple, it was a single leg or double leg. We'll have to slow that down. So, Taiji is talking about the rules. Apparently some kind of... Tai Chi guy doesn't want him doing a single leg or double leg or something. Man, they are going so hard. He's talking something else about rules. Tai Chi guy's gassed. Shit, I don't sound like him. You have any... things wrong, talk to the referee. So he's like, the guy violated the rules, I don't want to compete anymore. The student's saying, okay, just take a point off. Just, I if I violate the rules once, here they go. Oh, neon belly, neon belly. Dude, Tai Taichi guy's totally gonna throw a fit over the neon belly. Be like, come on, let's do it. And Shinsai says, you can only. Okay, then. Very courteous to you guys. He's like, anyone? Come on. Look at this. You wanna fight? Dude, Shu Xiao No should go to the WWE, man. Look at that. He's making fun of here. He's pretty good at sprawling. So he doesn't get taken down immediately. You see that sprawl?
Hey, come. 如果下来我们马上终止比赛，我们马上终止比赛。如果你们下来，我们马上终止比赛。东哥下去。所有人都上去，如果你们想看比赛，所有人都上去。大屏幕，只留裁判摄影，其他人全上去。我告诉你们，耽误时间，一会儿就打不了。好，比赛开始。 计时准备好了吗？往前，哎，这个架势很对。好，场边可以指导，是可以指导的。好，这一圈确实很快啊。 好，好，好，我们丁老师，我觉得刚才丁老师的表现已经大多展，哎，看这一拳展现出了很多咏春的技法。好，那么，好，没有地面，没有地面。比赛结束。
The Joe Rogan Experience.
Helsing Gracie, who's another famous jiu-jitsu practitioner, he was asked to describe jiu-jitsu, and he's like, I'm gonna paraphrase this, or I might fuck it up. He said it was basically like, I move, and then you move, and then I move, and then you move. Forever.
Forever.
That was his description of jiu-jitsu. I'm like, oh my god. So if you realize how good Helsing is, then yeah. It becomes a terrifying expression. Because it's like, yes. Eventually I'm going to get you, bitch.
Yes.
You're going to fuck up. You're going to get tired. You're going to be using too much strength. And you're going to get exhausted. Just like those boxers that were throwing punches and then they'd get tired. And the other guy would piece them up. Yeah. But it's going to be even more horrific. Because you're never going to be able to accomplish anything. You're just going to slowly wear out. The guy's just gonna keep attacking you, and you keep pushing him off you, and he's gonna keep attacking you, and you keep exploding, and he's gonna keep attacking you, and eventually you're gonna get tired. And then he's just gonna dominate you. He's just gonna control you. You'd be great at it, dude.
Yeah.
It'd be good for you. Yeah, it'd be really good for you.
All right, would I have to be in there with kids when I first start? Like,
they're gonna put you in the women and kids class.
Getting all jacked up.
They're gonna put you, here's how strong jiu-jitsu is. There was a woman named, she still exists, her name is Felicia Oh. She's a friend of mine, she's a black belt from Jean-Jacques Machado's. She's super technical, and Felicia's very strong, but she weighs about maybe 135 pounds. And there's a guy named Seymour Butts. Seymour Butts was a porn star who had a TV show on Showtime, and he had this idea, pretty bold of him, really, he's brave to do this. He just decided, I'm gonna do like a jiu-jitsu match. Well, I've never taken jiu-jitsu before.